Let us continue salt analysis. In the salt analysis, we have taken group 1 precipitate. The group 1 precipitate is treated with hot water. Then we are getting residue and filtrate. Residue we are taking. The residue is white precipitate. It may contain mercurous chloride or silver chloride. It may contain mercurous chloride or silver chloride. This is a white. It is treated with ammonia. It is treated with aqueous solution of ammonia. Then the contents are shaken very well. Then the contents are filtered. We are getting two possibilities now. One is residue, another one is filtrate. Another one is filtrate. If this residue is silver chloride, that silver chloride is soluble in ammonia to form complex. The complex is AgNH3 twice Cl. It is soluble complex. If this residue is AgCl, which dissolves in ammonia and forms complex AgNH3 twice Cl. If residue is mercurous chloride, that will react with ammonia. If residue is mercurous chloride, that will react with ammonia. Mercurous chloride reacts with ammonia to give this mercurous. Mercurous contains Hg plus 1. Mercurous contains Hg plus 1. One is undergoing reduction to give mercury. That is gray. Another one is undergoing oxidation to give mercuric. So another one is converting into mercuric. It is having plus 2 oxidation number. Next, this H plus in the NH3 H plus is there. That H plus takes Cl minus and becomes HCl. Then here H plus is leaving. After that, what is remaining? NH2 minus. NH2 minus you can write. NH2 minus. Remaining one Cl. Cl is having minus 1 charge. That Cl we have written. So plus 2, minus 2 charge is neutralized. It is called mercuric amido chloride. Mercuric amido chloride. It is white. The combination of both appears black. The combination of both this mercury and mercuric amido chloride combination of both appearing black. So your residue is this one, mercury plus mercuric amido chloride, which is a black residue. Black residue. Here the filtrate is so and so AgNH3 twice Cl. Okay. So this filtrate we will divide into two parts. This filtrate we will divide into two parts. To one part we will add dilute nitric acid. To one part we will add dilute nitric acid. To the another part we will add potassium iodide solution. Potassium iodide solution. To this filtrate we are dividing into two parts. To one part we will add dilute nitric acid solution. To another part we will add potassium iodide solution. Okay. So what happens? That we will see. This complex existing in what form and what is the reaction with this? That we will see. Now the filtrate contains soluble complex. The complex is AgNH3 twice Cl. It is undergoing ionization to give ions. Cation is this one, anion is this one. Cation, anion. This complex undergoes ionization. The complex undergoes ionization to give metal ion and ammonia. Metal ion and ammonia. Like this, equilibrium is possible. This complex undergoing ionization to give central metal ion Ag plus and ligand. Ligand is ammonia. Okay. To this, we are adding dilute nitric acid. Now, what will happen? Do you think? We are adding dilute nitric acid to this. What will happen? Do you think? What will happen? Do you think? What is the chemical reaction is possible? Do you think? Between which chemical reaction is possible, do you think? This dilute nitric acid, it is acid. HNO3 is acid. Here acid is there. You see, in this filtrate, what is present? This complex ion, this Cl minus, this ammonia, this Ag plus, this complex ion is present. It is an acid. Acid will react with what you think? Is it available? Do you think? Acid generally reacts with which one? Is that available or not? You see, if it is available, what will be the product that you see? It is an acid. It will react with what? Base. Is base available in the solution or not? You see, Ag plus is available. Ag NH3 twice plus is available. Cl minus is available. Is base available in the solution? Is it available? Okay. Ammonia. Ammonia is a base. So ammonia is a base. Nitric acid. It is an acid. So this acid and this base will react to give what? This is acid. It will react with this base to give what? Salt. What is that salt? What is that salt? It is ammonia. It is acid. Between these two, reaction is possible. Okay. So you will get a salt. In this, which is acid? HNO3. Which is base? Ammonia is the base. Sorry. Ammonia will act as which base? Lewis base or Lowry-Bronsted base or Arrhenius base? It will act as which base do you think? Ammonia will act as a base. Okay. Will it act as Lewis base? Will it act as Lowry-Bronsted base? Will it act as Arrhenius base? Which base it will act? Sir, ammonia is acting as a base which takes H plus or which donates H plus or which donates lone pair or which takes lone pair or it will give OH minus or what it will do it, do you think? Ammonia is acting as a base, we are saying. Okay, so ammonia will write. It is acting as a base in the sense, which base? Lewis base, Lowry-Bronsted base, which one we should understand it. Nitrogen comes under 5th group. So this valence shell is having 5 electrons. 5 electrons we have written. Lewis base. Now, this nitric acid we can write H plus and NO3 minus. So between this, dative bonding is possible. Due to dative bonding, this N takes this H plus. So N is having totally 4 hydrogens. So it will become NH4 plus. Ammonium. For this cation, this anion is there. That is NO3 minus. Ammonium nitrate. Sorry. So acid reacted with the base. Okay. What is the remaining in the system you see? In the solution. After this reaction, what is the remaining in the solution you see? What are the remaining? Ag plus is present. Cl minus is present. Ag plus and Cl means silver chloride. Silver chloride is soluble in water or insoluble in water? That remember that point. Recollect that point. AgCl is soluble in water or insoluble in water? You think it. Sorry. Due to addition of dilute nitric acid, this ammonia is going for chemical reaction. So what happens to the concentration of ammonia? What happens to the concentration of ammonia? Concentration of ammonia reduces. Therefore, this equilibrium is disturbed. So forward is favoring. So concentration of Ag plus rises. This Ag plus and this Cl minus will become what? AgCl precipitate or AgCl in solution form, soluble form. What do you think? What do you think, sir? Regarding halides, all the metal halides are soluble in water. All the metal halides are soluble in water. Exception. What is exception? What is exception here? Exception is one is cuprous halides. Next one is silver halides. Silver halides. Next one is mercurous halide. Next one is mercuric iodide. Next one is lead halide. These are insoluble in water. These are insoluble in water. Okay. All the metal halides are soluble in water except cuprous halide, silver halide, mercurous halide, mercuric iodide, lead halide, insoluble in water. Now see. Here the filtrate contains this equilibrium. This complex ionizes as like this. This complex ion is in equilibrium like this. Equilibrium in this way. You are adding dilute nitric acid. This nitric acid removes ammonia in the form of salt. So ammonia is removed. Therefore equilibrium is disturbed. So forward is favoring. So this complex ion is converting into Ag plus ions. Therefore, this concentration reduces. So this salt is ionizing continuously. Now, in the resultant solution, Ag plus concentration goes on increasing. This Ag plus and this Cl minus will become AgCl. That AgCl, AgCl will be precipitated or AgCl will remain in solution. What do you say? This Ag plus and this Cl minus becomes AgCl precipitate or AgCl will remain in solution. What do you say that? What do you say? AgCl will be precipitated or AgCl will be in the solution. AgCl will dissolve in solution if ammonia is there. But ammonia, is it there in the solution? You think it? Nitric acid is converting ammonia into ammonium ion. So is there any ammonia? This ammonium ion, can it act as a ligand? Can this ammonium ion act as ligand? It cannot act because it is not having, nitrogen is not having lone pair. Nitrogen is not having lone pair. So ammonium ion cannot act as Lewis base. So cannot act as ligand. Therefore, can ammonium ion coordinate with Ag plus? No. Ammonium ion cannot coordinate with Ag plus. So Ag plus is not having any ammonia to form a complex. So Ag plus is not having ammonia to form a complex. Therefore, only way for Ag plus is Cl minus. Ag plus and Cl minus is AgCl. AgCl is insoluble. Therefore, now what will happen? Do you see? What will happen here? what will happen on adding dilute nitric acid into the filtrate? Will you get a precipitate of AgCl, or will you have AgCl solution? Will you have AgCl solution? Which will you have it? AgCl precipitate, will you have it? Or AgCl solution, will you have it? Which will you get? Which will you get? You see this point? All the metal halides are soluble. Soluble in water. Except this, cuprous halide, silver halide, mercurous halide, mercuric iodide, lead halide are insoluble in water. Insoluble in water. You have taken the filtrate here. The filtrate contains like this complex. This complex on ionization gives like this ions. This complex ion is in equilibrium like this. Is in equilibrium like this. You are adding dilute nitric acid into this. You are adding dilute nitric acid into this. This nitric acid removes ammonia. Removes ammonia. So, what do you say regarding concentration of ammonia here? Concentration of ammonia here. Shall we say reduces? Shall we say concentration of ammonia reduces here? Concentration of ammonia reduces while equilibrium disturbs. Shall we say concentration of ammonia decreases? So equilibrium gets disturbing. Shall we say equilibrium is disturbing means forward is favoring. Shall we say forward favors in the sense concentration of free Ag plus increases. Shall we say this free Ag plus and this Cl minus will become what you think? This Ag plus will not convert into like this because no ammonia for this no ammonia. It is not getting any ammonia. It is not getting any ammonia in the sense. Will it convert to like this complex or will it become AgCl? That you think it. Will it become AgCl? Or will it become like this complex? What do you think? What do you say? Will it become AgCl? Or will it become like this complex? AgCl is insoluble. Okay? AgCl is insoluble. So, what is the result here? Will you get AgCl precipitate? Or will you get AgCl solution? Or will you get Ag plus complex like this? What you will get it? What will you get? What do you say? You are saying AgCl precipitate, sir. So you will get AgCl precipitate. Okay? AgCl precipitate, sir. Next, to this filtrate, let us add. To this filtrate, we will add a potassium iodide solution. To this filtrate, we will add potassium iodide solution. Okay. Now we will add a potassium iodide solution into this filtrate. What will happen? That we'll see. We will add potassium iodide into this filtrate. What happens? That we'll see. So we are adding potassium iodide solution. Potassium iodide solution, we will add it. What happens? Now see, this filtrate contains this complex. This filtrate contains this complex. This complex on ionization gives like this. This complex ion on ionization so and so produced. Now, between this complex ion and these ions, equilibrium is there. So in the filtrate, this undissociated complex is there, dissociated ions present, and the free ion Ag plus and free molecule ammonia present in this filtrate. Because in this filtrate, like this, equilibrium is possible. Now, all these are colorless. Potassium iodide solution also colorless. Now you say, due to addition of potassium iodide into this filtrate. Filtrate means filtrate contains this. In this filtrate, free ammonia molecules present, free Ag plus ions present, this positive complex ion is present, Cl minus ion is present, undissociated complex is present in this filtrate. The filtrate contains all the species. You are adding potassium iodide into this filtrate. What will happen? Do you think any precipitate? If you think any precipitate, what is the name of precipitate? And what is the color of precipitate? What do you think, sir? You are adding potassium iodide. Now, potassium iodide, is it a salt? Or is it an acid? Or is it a base? What do you think? If it is acid, we can say that it may react with this base. Okay. If you say this is as a salt, we need not think about acid-base reaction. Okay. Do you think that potassium iodide is acid or base or salt? Okay. Potassium iodide is which one? That we should know it. So, HI is an acid. KOH is a base. Acid base and reaction gives salt Ki and water. Sorry. So potassium iodide is a salt. Okay. Potassium iodide is a salt. It is a salt. Therefore, it is not reacting with this ammonia base. Okay. So between potassium iodide and ammonia, there is no reaction. Sorry. This point is okay. So potassium iodide, ammonia, no reaction. Sorry. Now, This iodide and Ag plus, anything will it be there? That you see. This Ag plus and I minus, one possibility AgI. AgI, one possibility. Next possibility we'll see. Ag plus Cl minus. What you will get? AgCl. AgCl. Sorry. Now we have seen two possibilities. This Ag plus cation, I minus anion. What is the compound? AgI compound. Ag plus cation, Cl minus anion. What is the compound? AgCl compound. Here ammonia is present. AgCl is present. AgI is present. What will happen? Do you have an idea? Sorry. Silver halides with ammonia. Silver halides with ammonia. How the solubility will be there, that we'll see. Silver halides with ammonia. AgCl is insoluble in water. It is soluble in ammonia due to formation of complex. The complex is AgNH3 twice plus. Sir, AgCl is insoluble in water, but it is soluble in ammonia due to formation of complex AgNH3 twice plus. Next we will take AgBr. AgBr is insoluble in water. It is pale yellow in color. AgCl is white precipitate. AgBr is pale yellow. It is insoluble in water. Soluble in concentrated ammonia due to formation of complex AgNH3 twice plus. Next, AgI. AgI is yellow precipitate. It is insoluble in water as well as insoluble in ammonia. Okay. So, behavior of silver halides with ammonia we have seen. Behavior of silver halides with ammonia, we got an idea. AgCl is soluble in aqueous ammonia. AgCl is soluble in aqueous ammonia. AgBr is soluble in concentrated ammonia. AgI is insoluble in ammonia. Now you say, you have taken the filtrate here. you have taken the filtrate contains these species. You are adding potassium iodide. This I minus and Ag plus, between them what will happen? You see one possibility, AgI. This AgI is insoluble in water, insoluble in ammonia. So between AgI and ammonia, nothing interaction. Between AgI and ammonia, nothing interaction. It is just precipitate. AgCl is insoluble in water but soluble in ammonia. So AgCl with ammonia interaction is there. What is the interaction? Complex formation is the interaction. Therefore, AgCl is soluble in ammonia. Sir, between these two, if there is any interaction, AgCl precipitate will form, but this AgCl precipitate will dissolve in ammonia and it will become solution. It will go back to solution. Between these two, if there is any interaction, you will get AgI precipitate. AgI will not interact with ammonia. Sir, so what are the possibilities? We said, as per the possibilities, we need not consider about AgCl. AgCl will not exist due to ammonia. You are adding potassium iodide. This I minus takes this Ag plus and becomes AgI. Due to formation of AgI, what happens to the concentration of Ag plus? You think it? Concentration of Ag plus reduces. So what will happen to equilibrium position? It will be affected. So which will favor? Forward is favoring. So forward is favoring means some more complex is converting into Ag plus. Here you are adding I minus. That I minus with Ag plus, AgI. So what happens to the concentration of Ag plus? Reduces. What happens to the position of equilibrium? Affected. What is favoring? Forward is favoring. So this complex ion is again converting into Ag plus. This I minus again taking Ag plus and becoming AgI. So due to addition of Ki, I minus continuously takes Ag plus and becoming AgI. This complex ion continuously converting into Ag plus ions and ammonia. So what is the result, do you say? To this filtrate, on adding potassium iodide solution, what will happen? What will happen? Do you get any precipitate? If it is so, what is the name of precipitate? What is the color of precipitate? Or do you get any other reactions? You are saying that due to addition of potassium iodide into the filtrate, we are getting yellow precipitate. That is AgI, you are saying. We are getting yellow precipitate. That is AgI. Silver iodide, yellow precipitate we are getting. Silver iodide, yellow precipitate we are getting. Sir, okay. Next, in the salt analysis, in the group separation of cations, first group analysis we discussed. Then we are going for second group. In the second group analysis, many cations we are going to discuss. But in syllabus, cation present is copper. Remaining cations will be used for advanced, JE advanced. Sorry. So in group 2, only copper ion is enough. But we will discuss more than copper ions. Those cations will be used for a JE advanced. Sorry. Now we will take group 2 precipitate. Group 2 precipitate. Group 2 precipitate is in sulfide form. Group 2 precipitate in sulfide form. To this, we will add yellow ammonium sulfide solution. yellow ammonium sulfide solution, we will add it. What will happen? Some of the group 2 precipitate dissolve in yellow ammonium sulfide on heating. Some will not dissolve. So some are dissolving and going to filtrate. Some are not dissolving, remaining as a residue. Sorry. In group 2 precipitate, what are the cations present? What are the cations present? In copper family, copper is present, cupric is present. Next group, zinc family. In zinc family, cadmium is present and mercuric is present. Cadmium and mercuric. In the carbon family, tin is having two oxidation states. One is plus 2, another one is plus 4. Another one is plus 4, both are possible. In carbon family, lead is possible, that is only plus 2 is possible. Nitrogen family, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Arsenic plus 3 is possible and plus 5 is possible. Plus 5 is possible. Arsenic plus 3 plus 5 oxidation states possible. Antimony plus 3 plus 5 oxidation states possible. Bismuth plus 3 oxidation state is possible. If you go for only JE advanced, you can study this alone. This is enough. This is enough. And this is enough. Only up to JE main or NEET means only these two rounded part is enough. Remaining sulfides are not required. Remaining sulfides are not required. Okay. JE advanced means remaining sulfides we have to read it. Sorry. Now, second group precipitate we have taken. To that we are adding yellow ammonium sulfide solution. Why we are saying, we can say just ammonium sulfide we can say no here. Ammonium sulfide we can say no. Why do we say yellow? Why do we mention the color? Sorry. Here, the yellow meaning is not indicating color. Okay, of course it is indicating color, but indication about some other. What does it indicate? That we will see. Now we will take ammonium sulfide. We will take it is ammonium sulfide solution which is colorless. See, ammonium sulfide is colorless solution. To this ammonium sulfide, we are adding sulfur, which is yellow. Sulfur solid we are adding and it is boiled. Ammonium sulfide solution is colorless. To this, we are adding yellow colored sulfur and it is boiled. We will get NH4 twice, SX times. Sulfur is X times. Sulfur is X times. X is greater than or equal to 2. So, this X indicates, due to this X, here sulfur present how many times means many times present, so that it is polymer. So, it is called polysulfide. Polysulfide. It is called what means polysulfide. Here cation is ammonium ion. Therefore, ammonium polysulfide. This ammonium polysulfide is yellow color. So this is called, simply this is called yellow ammonium sulfide solution. In the commercially it is called as yellow ammonium sulfide solution. So what is the chemical name of this? Ammonium polysulfide. Sir, this ammonium polysulfide is having what formula? What is the cation? NH4 plus. How many NH4 plus? 2 times. Polysulfide anion formula is SX2 minus. So this 2 minus how to split? For one sulfur minus 1, for another sulfur minus 1. If you give X is equal to 2, we have to write a bond like this. Between sulfur and sulfur, one single bond you have to give. Suppose if you give X is equal to 3, then 3 sulfur atoms will write and minus 2 will split into minus 1, minus 1. That minus 1 charges we will give to extreme sulfur atoms and bonding we will give like this. Now central sulfur is having oxidation number 0. It is S32-. Like this, X is equal to 4, 5, like this it continues. Okay. So NH4 twice SX is called ammonium polysulfide. It is yellow color. This is simply called as yellow ammonium sulfide solution. Sir, now to the group 2 precipitate. To the group 2 precipitate, yellow ammonium sulfide solution is added and boiled. We are getting residue, the boiled and filtered. We are getting residue and filtrate. Sir, what is the residue and what is the filtrate? That we will see. Residue contains this CuS. CuS is there in the residue. Then CdS is present in the residue. HgS is present in the residue. PbS is present in the residue. Ba2S3 present in the residue. This residue is a black precipitate. Black precipitate, it is these sulfides. CdS also present in the residue, which is yellow precipitate. Which is yellow precipitate. So, which are going to filtrate? That we'll see. Which are going to filtrate in the sense the two oxidation numbers are going to filtrate. Tin is having two oxidation numbers, arsenic is having two oxidation numbers, antimony is having two oxidation numbers. These are going to filtrate. So which is going to filtrate means, yes, tin is going to filtrate, arsenic, antimony. This tin, arsenic, antimony going to filtrate as thiostanates. Going to filtrate as a complex. The complex is thiostanates. So SNS, SNS2, AS2S3, AS2S5, SB2S3, SB2S5. These are going to filtrate due to formation of complex. The complex is thiostanates. There now, the sulfides which go to filtrate is considered as group 2B cations. The sulfides which do not go to filtrate, remain as residue, is considered as group 2A sulfides. Ba2S3 comes under 2A. Therefore, this residue is 2A sulfides, filtrate is 2B sulfides. So the sulfides which go to filtrate is coming under 2B. The sulfides which do not go to filtrate remain as residue, coming under 2A. So we got, we divided group 2 precipitate into 2A and 2B. Some of the metal sulfides coming under 2A residue, some of the metal sulfides coming under 2B. This classification is done by boiling the group 2 precipitate with the yellow ammonium sulfide solution. So, now we will see thiostanates we have written for tin, similarly for arsenic, similarly for bismuth, antimony. We will say complex. Thio complexes, that word we'll say. Thio complexes. This tin is going means thiostanates. Arsenic is going means thioarsenate. Antimony is going means thioantimonate.